playing and having fun.
It's me, Vincent, from the Nirks. Outer space is fascinating and beautiful, but it can also be a little bit spooky. Here are three of our favorite spooky space songs. Enjoy! And stay tuned. Meet the Undead Stars rises again with part two premiering October 10th, 2025.
There's a chill in the air, and the sky is changing. Darkness is falling, and the light is fading. Slowly rising over the horizon, you see an eerie sight. A reddish entity ascending up into the night. A blood moon in the sky, a ghostly figure catches your eye. A dark red color, I wonder why. There's a blood moon in the sky tonight. Blood moons occur during a total lunar eclipse. Earth's shadow blocks sun's light, making me look like this. A lunar eclipse can only happen when I'm full, when Earth is precisely between the sun and the moon. A lunar eclipse is only visible to half of the Earth each time. The other half misses out on the show because they're on Earth's other side. A blood moon in the sky, a ghostly figure catches your eye. A total lunar eclipse creates a fright. A blood moon in your sky tonight. The umbra is Earth's inner shadow. There are three main types of lunar eclipses, you know. A penumbral eclipse, some sunlight still reaches me. Because I only pass through Earth's outer shadow, you see. When I pass through part of the umbra, it's a partial eclipse. Some sunlight still reaches part of me. But in a total lunar eclipse, I'm in the umbra completely, and that is when you'll see. A blood moon in the sky, a ghostly figure catches your eye. Shrouded in shadow, what a creepy sight. A blood moon in the sky tonight. Even when in Earth's shadow, I have an eerie glow. Because some sunlight can pass through Earth's atmosphere, you know. Colors with short wavelengths like blue and purple won't make it through. These colors are filtered out, which is why I have a reddish hue. Red and orange colors have longer wavelengths and can make it through Earth's atmosphere. And the more dust or clouds in Earth's atmosphere, the redder I will appear. A blood moon in the sky, a ghostly figure catches your eye. An eerie glow of reddish light. There's a blood moon in the sky tonight.
Chill in the air, and the sky is changing. Darkness is falling, and the light is fading.
It doesn't happen often, on average 2 to 4 times annually. That is when the curious and fearless can all come out to see. A blood moon in the sky, a ghostly figure catches your eye. A total lunar eclipse creates a fright. There's a blood moon in the sky tonight.
When a star's life ends, it's not really the end. Some find ways to survive and live on, my friend. Some become something else entirely, transforming or feeding off others' energy. Spooky, eerie things happen in the depths of space. Clinging to life, some very strange things can take place. Dark mysteries that you won't believe. Don't be afraid. Let's see who we can meet.
I am a white dwarf star, ZTFJ 1813 plus 4251. I'm feeding off the hydrogen-rich atmosphere of my companion. I'll strip the star down to just a dense helium core. I'll become stronger, but soon it will be no more. We're a full eclipsing binary system, as close as it gets, with one of the fastest orbital periods only 51 minutes. Some would call me a vampire star, but officially, a cataclysmic variable is what we are.
Let's go meet the undead stars, lurking in outer space and hiding in the dark. These cosmic phantoms, they're haunting me, finding different ways to consume energy.
Let's go meet the undead stars, zombies, cannibals, and vampires, with white dwarf stars and neutron stars, fast-spinning pulsars and magnetars, dark, menacing black holes you cannot see, so many different kinds to meet. When one star ends, another begins. The mysteries behind them are drawing me in.
I'm Cannibal Star G238-44, but I don't feed off of another star to get more. I'm siphoning debris from my own planetary system, feeding on icy materials wherever I can find them. I used to be a star, just like your sun, but now I'm just a stellar corpse trying to hang on. Capturing materials from my own asteroid belt, you see. Whatever I need to keep feeding, I'm so hungry.
I'm a hot white zombie star left over from supernova SN1181. I'm all that's left over after a cataclysmic collision. Two stars collided, leaving behind me to take my turn. Just a stellar core remnant with no fuel left to burn. My supernova occurred in 1181, 800 years ago, and I still live on. Surrounded by an epically beautiful nebula display, I look like the center of a giant firework today.
Let's go meet the undead stars, lurking in outer space and hiding in the dark. These cosmic phantoms, they're haunting me, finding different ways to consume energy. Let's go meet the undead stars, zombies, cannibals, and vampires, with white dwarf stars and neutron stars, fast-spinning pulsars and magnetars, dark, menacing black holes you cannot see, so many different kinds to meet. When one star ends, another begins. The mysteries behind them are drawing me in.
RxJ1856-5-3754, left over from a supernova. I'm not like other neutron stars you've met before. I'm a radio silent neutron star. I don't make a peep. I'm extremely hot, but other than that, I show no activity. I'm also a runaway star traveling at great velocity, resulting in a bowshock-type nebula near me. It's strange how the end of another star resulted in my birth. Now I'm part of the Magnificent Seven group of neutron stars located near Earth.
I'm a type of neutron star called a magnetar, you see. One of the most magnetized objects known, I'm SGR-1806-20. In less than a second, I release energy equal to the sun's energy output over 100,000 years, like the giant gamma ray flare I had that lit up Earth's atmosphere.
Let's go meet the undead stars, lurking in outer space and hiding in the dark. These cosmic phantoms, they're haunting me, finding different ways to consume energy. Let's go meet the undead stars, zombies, cannibals, and vampires, with white dwarf stars and neutron stars, fast-spinning pulsars and magnetars, dark, menacing black holes you cannot see, so many different kinds to meet. When one star ends, another begins. The mysteries behind them are drawing me in. I'm known as the Lich Pulsar, an undead, rapidly spinning, pulsating neutron star. A millisecond pulsar, I spin 161 times per second. I'm left over from a giant star supernova, I reckon. I have three undead planets that orbit me, that I continually zap with my radiation energy. Their names are Dragoor, Phobator, and Poltergeist. And my constant pulses light up auroras in their skies like the northern lights.
I'm a black hole, GRO-J1655-40. Nothing, not even light, can escape me. Left over from a supernova long ago. A dark hole in space drifting through the cosmos. I'm not alone, though. I have a companion star orbiting me, providing me with lots of tasty material and energy. I'm devouring the star as it orbits me every 2.6 days, giving me what I need to be a microquasar from which nothing escapes.
Let's go meet the undead stars, lurking in outer space and hiding in the dark. These cosmic phantoms, they're haunting me, finding different ways to consume energy. Let's go meet the undead stars, zombies, cannibals, and vampires, with white dwarf stars and neutron stars, fast-spinning pulsars and magnetars, dark, menacing black holes you cannot see, so many different kinds to meet. When one star ends, another begins. The mysteries behind them are drawing me in.
When a star's life ends, it's not really the end. Some find ways to survive and live on, my friend. dark mysteries that you won't believe. Don't be afraid. Let's see who we can meet.
This next video is cool, but maybe a little too scary for younger children. When we first filmed it a few years back, I was too scared to be in the video because I thought the black hole might swallow me. But as it turns out, Bernie, the black hole in this video, is really a nice guy, and he has promised not to swallow any of us.
Deepest darkest reaches of space, you will find me. No matter, no light can ever escape. From my gravity and darkness itself, you cannot hide. When a star supernova's on what's left behind. When stars' life ends and my life begins, I consume everything around me by pulling it in. Let's go meet a black hole. Once I have a hold of you, I never let go. Come and meet a black hole. What lies beyond me, nobody knows. Only a few main parts make up my anatomy. The point at my center where the star collapsed is called my singularity. This point has infinite gravity and mass density, where the laws of physics change and space-time curves infinitely. My event horizon is the point of no return. The edge where once crossed, not even light can escape or burn. Its circumference is around my singularity. The gravity's too strong here, nothing can reach escape velocity. My ergosphere is the space outside my event horizon, where my gravity pulls all objects in that region into motion. Objects here can no longer stay stationary or still, but they could still escape me. If they had the will, the stellar objects, gas, and debris that circle around me is called my accretion disk and is the only way you can see me. Past my event horizon, my center is pure darkness. The disk disappears when there's nothing left to consume. I will just be blackness. My singularity's gravity is so strong that I distort time. It's a very weird anomaly that will totally blow your mind. From an observer far away, time appears to go slower. For objects approaching my event horizon that are about to cross over. Let's go meet a black hole. Once I get a hold of you, I never let go. Come and meet a black hole. What lies beyond me, nobody knows. Deepest, darkest reaches of space, you will find me. No matter, no light can ever escape. From my gravity and darkness itself, you cannot hide. When a star supernova's on what's left behind. When star's life ends and my life begins, I consume everything around me by pulling it in. Let's go meet a black hole. Once I have a hold of you, I'll never let go. Come and meet a black hole. What lies beyond me, nobody knows. Did you know there's a black hole at the center of the Milky Way? It's a supermassive black hole known as Sagittarius A. Supermassive black holes can be found at the center of most spiral galaxies and are hundreds of millions, if not billions, times more massive than any star we see. Other famous black holes, M87, Cygnus X1, and Centaurus A. Did an elliptical galaxy, Messier 87, eject superheated material away? Cygnus X1's a binary system, blue supergiant and black hole emitting X-rays. And supermassive spiral galaxy black hole with two bright jet streams is Centaurus A. Black holes can be anywhere out there in space, you know. Especially if our accretion disk is done, nothing left to show. just a dark spot in the universe for someone to stumble upon. Don't get too close or I'll pull you in and then you'll be gone. Let's go meet a black hole. Once I get a hold of you, I'll never let go. Come and meet the black hole. What lies beyond me, nobody knows.
Year is really scary.
Yeah, tell me about it!